Good morning, good afternoon, or good evening. My name is Ms. D. Taylor, and this is Mr.
It's Mr. Ware.
We are welcoming you to the Parent Night 2021-2022 school year. This PowerPoint is to tell you about the students and our expectations for the children in the classroom. Our goal is to provide a successful and safe learning environment for each individual student, to encourage parents to be actively involved in the school environment. These are our guidelines for success. Make good choices, involve yourself responsibly, listen, learn all you can, excel beyond expectation, respect yourselves and others. We have check-in procedures, which means that we are telling the students in the classroom when we're preparing for our lesson, our conversational levels, whether it's going to be zero if the teacher's talking, or whether they're working in groups. If they need help, they're going to raise their hand. The activity that we're going to do, whether we're doing math, science, reading, social studies, or language arts, and we explain to them what the movement is while we're providing instruction and how they're supposed to participate. These are a list of the consequences. I'm not going to really go through them, but we'd just like to let you know before we write a referral. And so one of them is we give them a warning or redirection. We may mark their planner. They may lose a privilege, like they may be able not be able to speak during lunch or something like that. Or we may, move them to another classroom so that they can do a cool down. Or we'll call home and talk to the parent.
Student expectations, to make sure that they arrive on time to school. School starts at 8:20. To make sure they turn in their homework daily, to make sure they keep their area neat and orderly, especially with COVID running rampant. Just want to make sure that their area is clean and make sure they continue to sanitize their area daily. To complete and turn in all assignments on time, there will be a deduction in points for late assignments that are turned in. Follow guidelines for success, as we Ms. Taylor talked about in the previous slide, and to be responsible and respectful at all times. That means to their classmates and others around the building. Homework. Homework should be given Monday through Thursday. Homework must be completed nightly. Parents initial the planner nightly, please, to make sure that you check that your child's work is done, especially the homework. And work turned in will be zero after the fourth day. So they will have time to turn in a late assignment, but after a certain period of time, it will be considered a zero. This is the breakdown of the grading. And this is how it works. Our major grades are 50%, so that'll be any tests, quizzes, anything like that, projects, that'll be considered a major grade. Our minor grades are our daily classwork we do inside the classroom, and then the other will be homework in class participation, which is a 15%. Our daily class schedule goes as follows. The arrival time for the kids is usually from 8 to 8:30. Announcements get started around 8:35. After announcements are over with, just depending on the classroom or the homeroom that your child is in, they'll either be in math or reading from 8:30 to 10:15. And then science and language arts starts at 10:15 to 10:30. From 10:30 to 11:15, they have their elective time. Once electives is over with, we go to lunch from 11:25 to 12:15. After 12:15, we transition back into math and reading from 12:15 to 2:20. And then from 2:20 to 3:05 is where they have science and language arts. And then at the end of the day, they do social studies from 3:05 to 3:40. And at 3:50, we start our dismissal process. Parent expectations. Please provide a written excuse when your child is absent. That way that we can ensure that their absence goes into excused absence. Please make sure you check the planner nightly. We often put important information in there. If we need you to look at it, just make sure you check the planner nightly. Then send a written notice of transportation changes. If you want your child to either go from a bus rider to a car rider, you have to have a written notice. And bring it to the front office so they can make the changes. The state of Texas requires that a student pass both the reading and math portions of the STAR to be promoted to the seventh grade. They will be taking STAR this year, unlike I think last year and the year before. They didn't really get a chance to take it properly, but with us being in a full school year and actually in school, they will be required to take the STAR test this year, and they must pass it in order to be promoted to the next grade. And they also must pass their classes too to be promoted to the next grade. How to reach both of us, Ms. Taylor and I have both put our emails up here, also with the school phone number. Our conference times are from 10:35 to 11:15. Conferences will be scheduled Tuesday through Thursday, not on Monday, not on Friday.
If you have any questions, just please let us know. We hope that this has been informative for you. And if you need anything, you have our email addresses, and we will be happy to communicate with you at any time. Have a great day.
Thank you.